Hi everybody, today is February 9th, 2013. U.S. military veterans asked to speak about UFO sightings over nuclear sites. Noted UFO researcher Robert Haskins is asking U.S. military veterans to contact him regarding their UFO-related experience at nuclear missile sites, weapon storage areas, and atomic thermal nuclear bomb test sites during the Cold War era and beyond. On September 27, 2010, Haskins co-sponsored the UFOs and Nuke press conference at the National Press Club in Washington, D.C., which CNN streamed live. The full-length video of the event may be viewed at, and they give you a link here. During the press conference, seven U.S. Air Force veterans discussed UFO incursions at ICBM sites at Maelstrom Air Force Base in Montana, F.E. Warren Air Force Base in Wyoming, and Walker Air Force Base, New Mexico, as well as the weapons storage area at RAF Bentwater, England. The incident at Maelstrom on March 24, 1967, involved several missiles inexplicably malfunctioning moments after security personnel reported observing a glowing disc-shaped craft hovering over the Oscar Flight Launch Control Facility. Other UFO sightings by civilians near the facility have been reported as recently as September 2012. At one time he was at the college in Aberdeen, South Dakota, and this is all he's basically interested in is UFO encounters at nuclear sites. He's not interested in hearing about other people's experiences of UFOs unless they're related to nuclear weapons. Similar incidents have occurred at various ICBMs bases over the years, according to other veterans interviewed by Haskins. UFOs also reportedly hovered over nuclear bomb storage areas and B-52 bomber alert pads. Declassified documents relating to some of these incidents may be read at, and they give another link here. Currently, Haskins is chiefly interested in sightings occurring during the October 1962 Cuban Missile Crisis, as well as those that took place over the past decade. However, he's also seeking information relating to any UFO sighting involving nuclear weapons. Haskins hopes to publish as many reports as possible once they have been vetted, but requests for confidentiality will be honored. Haskins notes that Soviet Army veterans have revealed cases of UFO activity at nuclear weapons sites in the former USSR. Those events have been confirmed by KGB or Ministry of Defense documents, including one occurring on October 4, 1982, during which nuclear missiles temporarily activated just as a disc-shaped craft hovered above them. Elsewhere, on July 28 and 29, 1989, another UFO hovered over a Soviet nuclear missile warhead depot and directed laser-like beams into it. Haskins believes that the American people and citizens of all nations deserve to know the facts regarding the reality of UFOs and the ongoing situation involving our nuclear weapons. Military veteran testimony will greatly contribute to this objective. He may be contacted at UFOHastingsAOL.com. But like I said, he's only interested in UFOs at nuclear sites. Don't waste your time in sharing other information about other UFO sightings, because he's just not interested in those. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.